haven't done it since I was like fucking 4 either. How would you calm down?
Every once in a while I go, can I still do this? Oh. All right, you want to see the real fucking sound, kid?
That was the stupidest shit.
That was not the sound I wanted to be. I had a similar sound I was trying to make. I landed on this. Here's what I landed on. Does that sound as crazy as it sounds in my head? Is that not nuts?
What the fuck?
Okay, how about this? And then I could just go. Right? Like you're going to die. Like.
Why is that? You're gonna die.
Yeah, it's I have cartoon dies.
I could do like weird shit. I was
a
double jointed like thumb kid that could do like weird shit. What the fuck? Those are like 6 different characters you just.
Yeah, played. I know. I got some sounds.
No, but you tried to act like they were. Oh, what, I think you just can't consistently. Okay,
I think I got. And then I got, which I think is what kind of amateur. And then there's the big kahuna is. Right.
All your characters are speaking the same language.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, that's like a form of alien.
Yeah, yeah,
sure.
Yeah. They're just all different ages and sizes.
Are they? I can't even. I can't tell you.
I'm not gonna lie to you.
And then I did the whole like learning these things. Right.
Yeah, I never got into
it. Was a sound kid. Yeah.
Yeah, you were a sound kid.
It's like making sounds.
Yeah, I don't know if I was a sound kid. I wasn't a sound kid actually.
All right.
I was a sports kid.
I was in justice. Does your kid play sports? No, he just does sounds mainly. He just, what do you mean? Like I take my son to baseball practice for 2 hours. Yeah, he's just in his room making sounds.
we don't know what they mean.
I don't know. They all seem kind of the same language. He's really into it. But no, it's just like bored. I feel like I developed the sounds in the backseat of the car.
He's Nucky. I saw somebody in the comments saying they want to take Nucky off my hands. If you mean that, if you truly fucking mean that, DM me, send me pictures of where Nucky is going, how you're gonna treat him. Give me his actual itinerary for the first week that he's there. Let me know what his fucking week looks like. He's very high maintenance. He doesn't know it yet.
Are you serious though? Like, if they send a beautiful place and they're like. And really, I'm a dog whisperer. Like, are you really going to get rid of
I'll do a whole fucking portion of the show called Nucky Updates. And they just send us videos of Nucky
and
Updates.
And, like, Nucky goes away to, like, a farm?
I mean, does Nucky really need me?
Like chases shadows for the rest of his life? I kind of miss him.
I love Nucky. I'll miss him. I didn't say I wouldn't miss him, but I think he's better off not in this home. And it's not that I don't want him here. Because he's a liability, Chris. I can't control Nucky, and I don't want to control him.
Yeah.
I want him to be able to be who he is. That's a murderer? Then go out with the rest of the murderers, dogs, and do your thing. But don't bring that shit here.
Wow.
I don't want you biting motherfuckers' toes and stuff on this podcast. Chris, how many times have you got your toes bitten by Nucky?
4 or 5.
4 or 5. You think that's a problem?
I mean, you know, it's just his brain's broke. I can't blame
right
Nucky.
Yeah, because his brain's broke.
Sometimes people's got broke brains. Welcome to Wine and Weed.
Yeah, we're back. We're back. We're back.
We're back. After a lot of weeks of guests.
We have,
a lot of great weeks of great guests.
Yeah, we wanted to be consistent and get some guests going. We might get a couple more if we can. You know, right now we're on fucking real quarantine again. We're on lockdown again, so we're trying to play it safe, be whatever we're gonna be and do and respect the actual rules. So we may or may not end the year with some guests, but we're gonna try to squeeze a couple more in if we can.
Yeah.
But yeah, we had a lot of good guests. Last week, I loved last week's episode.
Yeah, she was great.
Yeah, Sam J was amazing. And now we're back this week with just us, man.
It's just us.
Just me and you, man. Well, Lana's here, but she's in the back. She's hanging out. What's up, girl?
That's shout out to Lana.
Oh, you changed your voice for Lana?
I don't know. It went higher than I expected it to.
It sounded good. I thought you were Lana. Oh my God, Lana? Is that you?
Yeah. I'm Chris Reinecker, a.k.a. The Chronic Sewer, a.k.a. The Goop in Your Gap, a.k.a. Speed Bump, a.k.a. Saxophone Jones.
Cool. La La and Saxophone. And
with me, as always, over here,
Sterling. I'm one of your other hosts, Sterling Steelo, Rim, aka Skateboard Steve, aka S of the Beach and your best of the breed, aka is our third leg, now it's just me, aka Concerned Father, aka Black Mama, aka RP Black Mamba, aka Steezington, aka your stylist, and last but not least, aka your Uncle Elroy.
And John Ross will be reading the facts from
via satellite.
A satellite somewhere. What's up, John?
Hey, everybody. It is I, John Ross, aka the Gorilla in Manila, aka Shark Boy, aka Young Jeff Goldblum, aka Spider-Man's best friend, aka Brown Peter Griffin, aka the Keto King, the Article Assassin, Terry Khalifa, and of course Big Sexy with the glasses.
And welcome to another week of Wine and Weed.
Yeah, get the energy back
up.
Let's get this shit going. You know what it is, Chris? We're drinking this Pinot Noir this time. You know what I'm saying? We'd be on cabs normally. We'd be on that cab sav or whatever we called it. But now we're on this Pinot Noir. It's a little lighter. It's pretty. La Crema.
La Crema. Yeah. From, the Central Coast of California.
Yeah, you know where it is.
Monterey.
And then we are smoking some CBX. What are we smoking?
Some CBX, some Super Silver Haze, and some La Orange.
You rolled up too?
No, I rolled up the La Orange.
Okay.
Which was great last time.
Okay, cool.
And got me very high very quickly.
Perfect. I don't think I smoked that one last time. I think I'll smoke a Silver Haze. I'm excited for this. And we are back. If you don't know about this show, each week what we do is, this is a comedy podcast, but we go over things within the news. It's a topical podcast. And we cover everything from politics to comedy to crazy things in the news and everything in between, sports, and a lot of sports and shit went on this weekend. Did you watch this fight, dude?
The Mike Tyson one or the Jake Paul one?
Doesn't matter. It was on the same fucking...
Oh, they were the same night? No, yeah. I didn't watch
Not same night, the same actual bill.
Oh, I was wondering why everybody was talking about Jake Paul. I kind of checked out from the news and was spending time with my family, so I came back and everyone was talking about this guy being knocked out by Jake Paul.
This guy, don't put Virgil? Some fucking respect on his fucking. That's Nate Robinson.
Nate Robinson. There's a different meme.
Nate Robinson, 3-time dunk NBA slam dunk contest champion.
I didn't know the hype for this Jake Paul event.
Come on, Chris. Why don't you never want to be in touch with pop culture? You love Jake Paul. Now all of a sudden you're trying to act like you don't watch and listen to Jake Paul shit. Look, Jake Paul and Nate Robinson fought, and I ain't gonna front. I was one of those people who gave Nate Robinson strength points just off being black. I just threw a nigga a couple points off the strength of being black. I was like, you know what? He's an elite athlete. He's an NBA player. He's a ex-All-American football player. He's a superior athlete. He's been doing this for years, whether or not it's boxing or not. I still feel like maybe he can train for 4 or 5 months and get some shit together and figure it out. Jake Paul's been fighting for now, I would say, 2 years, 2.5 years.
He knocked him out?
Oh, no, he flattened that man. He put that man on the canvas with his arms to the side, flat-faced it on the fucking shit.
I believe I saw the photo, yeah.
I will say this much. I don't know where I land still. Part of me feels like it was fake. Part of me feels like we're watching some stage shit right before our eyes. We're watching the WWE.
Would Nate Robinson do that?
Listen. I don't know what Nate Robinson would do. I don't know what Nate Robinson's financial books look like. I don't know what Nate Robinson is in life. But what I do know is Jake Paul beat his ass, right? And Jake Paul knocked his ass down 3 times. Knocked him out once. Flat face. Knocked him out. Knocked him out. They had to bring people in. It felt to me choreographed. Now, at the end of the day, I've seen Jake Paul doing some boxing outside of Nate Robinson. He's been sparring and shit. And he really is looking like he's getting to become a good boxer. He actually showing hands. He has good form. He hits actually kind of hard. I get why, like, Jake Paul could actually do okay in the sport, right? But I also am realistic. When I look at the sport and what these kids are doing, I look at this WWE. I look at these dudes as entertainers. I look at boxing as boxing, and you try to sell fight to entertain a little bit with the boxing that you do for boxers, the Errol Spencers of the world, the Canelo Alvarez of the world, the Triple G's of the world. Those dudes are boxers, and they try to do a little entertaining.
You're saying the Pauls are bringing such a big audience.
They're bringing entertainment to boxing. It's a
and
different.
And so they're starting to turn. Would they turn to, like, would the boxing purists want to turn it into WWE?
I don't think boxing purists would, but I think that if nothing else, you have to respect they hustle. They're showing that there are other ways to get money in markets that may have looked like they were already cornered. In markets and in sports and different things that may have looked like they were already cornered, there are other ways to make money. I think the first glimpse of it was the Chris Brown Soulja Boy shit. People thought Chris Brown and Soulja Boy were going to fight. And people were really hyped about it. I was super hyped about it. I was like, ooh, Chris Brown. Do we have a lighter, baby? I was like, Chris Brown and Soulja Boy, this is going to be crazy. It's going to be dope. And it never happened, right? Cool. I think with that being said, though, it opened up people's eyes for like, damn, there was a whole bunch of interest there to watch Chris Brown and Soulja Boy fight, even though they never did. So the first time those kids fought was, I think, Logan Paul fought KSI. Jake Paul fought his brother.
Right.
And then they fought again. Jake Paul ended up fighting another YouTube kid. I don't know all these kids' names. But ended up fighting another YouTube kid. He beat that kid. And then he started taking boxing seriously. And I think Nate Robinson, if you were to ask me, is nothing but a stepping stone for these kids, right? I think that they knew, because you don't know where this is going. Let me tell you where this is going, big picture. Next year, Logan Paul will fight Floyd Mayweather.
Yeah, see, I see.
And Jake Paul will fight Conor McGregor.
You think so?
For a fact. For a fact.
Jake Paul fighting Conor McGregor.
It will be Logan Paul versus fucking Floyd Mayweather and Jake Paul versus Conor McGregor. If I'm predicting right, on the same bill, I think on the same bill, they'll think it's going to be the biggest pay-per-view moment in history. It may be. I don't fucking know.
So the Pauls are really bringing that audience to boxing in that.
They're bringing an audience. Floyd Mayweather and Conor McGregor are obviously the biggest you can do. The best you can go. They're doing enough in the space that you at least have to respect that they're making money.
Yeah.
Like some of these boxers who people love are still only clocking in 100,000, 50,000.
But is it weird if you're Conor McGregor that like, you're kind of taking the second build fight? Like, you know what I'm saying?
It's not weird. I'll tell you why it's not weird. Because it doesn't matter. They're going to label it as a double main event anyway.
Okay.
It doesn't matter. They may get a smaller share, right? But it still doesn't matter. Conor McGregor wasn't going to... He made money from the Floyd Mayweather fight. He made the most he ever made from Floyd. So he knows attaching his name to Floyd is the biggest you can go.
Yeah.
So he knows, okay, I'm going to fight... If I'm not fighting Floyd, I'm going to fight this kid, Jake Paul. And we're going to do it in boxing. I honestly think that fight could be interesting. I think Conor McGregor's a striker. I don't think he's that great of a boxer. I think he's a striker. I don't think he's that great of a boxer. Now, they're not using their legs and shit, Chris, because you look confused. Also, Jake Paul is...
Oh, because Conor McGregor's from MMA.
Yes.
Right.
And Jake Paul and Logan are way bigger than both those guys.
Right.
Like, you got to think about that, too.
Yeah, I just
but
remembered that.
I think that those kids are going to make a shit ton of money next year. I salute them for the way they've pivoted and made themselves into these other things other than being YouTube stars and just YouTube stars.
Yeah, it was
now
really,
pivot, it's very,
it was really a unique way of thinking about this
whole
thing.
Very unique.
Which they've, to their benefit, I mean, to their, you know, to talk good about them, even if I don't, like, love everything they've done, just their path that they've chosen along the entire way of monetizing off of merch and kind of being the pioneers in that space and then now monetizing this whole new way that nobody was really doing before.
They figured it out.
Are pretty two pretty cool plays.
It is.
To pull off of there.
They figured it out. Well,
shitty YouTube.
Mike Tyson ended up fighting Roy Jones Jr. also on that last bill, which was interesting. It wasn't.
I keep on picturing Roy Wood Jr. But
no, Roy Jones Jr. He's a legend.
Yeah.
But they I don't know. That fight wasn't real. So it was interesting. But okay.
We have an article about it. Should we hit it?
Yeah, that's what I'm starting with this one. But wait, really quick. The last thing I'll say. For me, again, it closes out. I don't think the Nate Robinson thing was real for a couple of reasons. If Nate Robinson wins, where does he go? Who's he fight? I think he was used to simply show that Jake Paul, you guys are saying Jake Paul just fought YouTubers. Now we can argue Jake Paul fought an athlete. A certified athlete. and he beat this certified athlete. So now you have to put him into a category of maybe Jake Paul is more of an athlete than we're giving him credit. And I think that is the case. I think that some people are looking at videos and shit and realizing, oh shit, Jake Paul actually hit hard. And he actually is becoming a decent fucking boxer. And he's only 23 years old. He's still young, so he's still like learning the sport of boxing. I don't think he ever fights a real fight. I don't think he ever fights Errol Spence or Terrence Crawford or any real motherfuckers. But I think that it's still cool that these dudes are selling out arenas and doing all type of shit on the zone and doing their own stuff, and they're making millions off of it just off throwing their own fights. It's fucking unique and cool shit.
Yeah.
But yeah, again, that's Mike Tyson. And
Mike Tyson says he was high during Roy Jones Jr. fight. Say what you will about Mike Tyson, at least he's consistent. The former champ started a marijuana company after leaving the boxing world behind, and he recently admitted that he dodged drug tests during his career using a fake penis. So it should come as no surprise that Tyson claims he was high during the fight with Roy Jones Jr. Absolutely, yes. Listen, I can't stop smoking, he told reporters after the fight. I smoke during fights. I just have to smoke. I'm sorry. I'm a smoker. I smoke every day. I never stop smoking. Tyson said that him and smoking are a package deal and that it has never affected his abilities in the ring. It's just who I am, he said. It has no effect on me with a negative standpoint. It's just what I do and how I am and how I'm going to die. There's no explanation. There's no beginning. There's no end. In a coincidence that either proves the universe is beautiful or the simulation is glitching, a faded Tyson said his fight commented on by none other than Snoop Dogg. The rapper's asides, jokes, and songs spread quickly on social media, with some viewers calling on Snoop to become a sportscaster full-time.
Wow. I mean, I think that's, you know, we're always told, like, that weed will make you, like, slow and lazy and not able to work, and Mike Tyson's, like, and dumb when you're old, and Mike Tyson is this fast athlete when he's old, and Snoop Dogg is a multi-talented presenter, actor, rapper, and both of them are really subverting the weed stereotype.
Well, and Mike Tyson's also hitting his stride, I think, in his career and how he's been looked at. I think people have really been uniquely open to Mike Tyson bouncing back. And you know, Mike Tyson has like bad stuff attached to his name. Yeah. I love Mike Tyson.
Right.
I don't want Mike Tyson to get canceled or nothing like that. Don't fuck with it. But I think that Mike Tyson is a great example of, I'll say, second chances. And
yeah.
People realizing that people can grow. I think Mike Tyson, when you hear him speak now, you hear a different Mike Tyson.
I agree with you.
You feel a different person. You feel growth. You feel like, this man, who the fuck is this individual? And I think that's because this man has, like, battled a lot of fucking demons, and I think weed is somewhat helping him with it as well.
Yeah, I mean, if you listen to him on his podcast, he's like this very
poised,
therapy-minded person now. Like, everything he says, like, really shows that he, like, does the work and does it on himself and is, like, very open.
I mean, he broke Boosie down. That was an individual that I think I say definitely within the black community we looked at as only one way. Like, you know, Boosie is, like, a real nigga. Boosie, you know, he one of them dudes. So to watch Mike Tyson really break him down and talk to him in a way that you got to watch a man be vulnerable, the biggest man or the toughest man or however you want to be viewed, to watch that man still, in a lot of ways, you watched Mike Tyson tap into the child of him. You watched that man become small, and not in a bad way, in a very vulnerable and a powerful way.
Yeah.
You watched, you know what I'm saying, two men have a real heart-to-heart. So I think Mike Tyson has grown a lot, and I don't know if I would, you know, credit all of it to marijuana at all, but I think that's something that he definitely uses to, you know, to keep calm and to kind of
through,
battle these
yeah.
things, yeah.
Yeah.
Mike Tyson's ill. I fuck with Mike Tyson a long way.
I think you're right of, like, taking the most kind of, like, masculine figures or hyper, whatever we look at as masculine, even though those moments of vulnerability do show strength. And now you take the strongest guy, mm-hmm. the, like, guy who is the fighter, the true strongman, and for him to adapt. Like, and also that's the right move in my mind to, you know, if you've done these bad things, like, to show that there's a path to hopefully becoming a better man.
And for me, and for Snoop, I'm just fucking jealous. I'm just jealous as shit because it's what I naturally do during fucking sports and watching sports. And I've always said that I felt like sports was missing a comedic voice in like commentating sports. I think there's a voice for comedy in commentating sports, and they've never done it. And people always be like Charles Barkley. I'm like, Charles is close. And I'm not saying Charles isn't good at what he does, but I'm like a true funny person talking sports that knows sports. And I love what Snoop did. Yeah. He fucking killed it. He was talking to shit, and he literally was the star of the night. Like, everyone left. You saw tweets and impressions. They were talking about the impressions, but they saw tweets and Instagram posts and everything just saying, if nothing else, people need to offer Snoop a contract. And I think they did,
for $15 million.
I think he said he would entertain for $15 million.
Right, right.
British Airways investigating reports stewardess is offering sexual services between flights. Passengers are also promised unspecified adult entertainment on board. British Airways is investigating reports that one of its Heathrow-based stewardesses is selling sex and her undergarments during and in between flights. Photos of the flight attendant's risque advertisements on social media were first reported by The Sun. The photos show her in a variety of suggestive poses while in uniform on the plane. For $33, a passenger can be the new owner of her underwear twice. That will be a securing fee where a prospective client can meet her at a hotel, according to the paper. Passengers are also promised unspecified adult entertainment on board if the price is right.
What is, all you is have this to from do... a website? Is this from OnlyFans?
She must have had like
it's a different website, I believe, where girls are selling their underwear now.
Yeah, okay. This is not OnlyFans.
No, it's not. It's like a whole new thing.
OnlyFans
like
won't allow you to sell your underwear.
Okay, so, but she does, but does she tell them what flight she's going to be on? How do they know? I'm confused.
All you have
she's
to
Heathrow
do,
based. I don't know. Delta, right?
Oh, she's British advertising Airways. It on the site, and then yeah, maybe you can like saying. Book a flight. Yeah.
And
yeah.
then she's like, here's my schedule, book a flight. That sounds dangerous.
No, I also think she might just be fucking these dudes with her stewardess outfit on, fam. Mm. And I don't know if that's illegal. I think what she's saying is like, hey, for $33, you can buy my panties that I wore one time.
Yeah.
On a fucking flight from LA to Vegas. Or she's like, hey, but for $66, you can fucking buy me a drink. Or I don't know. But then it continues to go up. And then she's like, for $500, you can meet me at the fucking hotel.
Between flights. But between flights just kind of makes it sound.
But yeah,
it's, just, it's storytelling,
yeah,
really.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. She's not between flights.
Yeah, no.
She hasn't worked there in two years.
She has some days off. She worked there long enough to take that one panty photo in the airplane. Wait, let's hear her real story.
I was trying to see what website she was selling them on.
Okay.
Because it's an actual thing, but
I just imagine you're like way deep in the website.
It's called Sophia Gray.
All you have to do is give me a sum of money and you'll be treated to a whole different experience of your choice, she allegedly wrote. After the first report of the alleged advertisements, her social media accounts appeared to have been deleted. In a statement to Fox News, the airline said it had launched an investigation to identify the mystery stewardess. We expect the highest standard of behavior from all our colleagues at all times, and we are investigating the claims, the airline said.
Someone snitched on her.
It's always that stewardess. That's mad they couldn't do it. Yeah, somebody was like, you're doing what? She was like, I'm making a killing. And they were like, all right, bitch, you cut me in or I'm snitching. I don't think that's cool, man.
It was Delta?
No, it's British Airways.
British Airways.
Did you have the logo in the things, or did they just find out through the backdoor social media flag?
Oh, this is like...
Do you have the photo?
But is that illegal? If I don't give you my name tag and the actual logo from the actual airline company, is it illegal for me to take pictures in this little get-up?
Okay, we're looking at some photos of a flight attendant taking underwear shots in a hotel and then just a regular one, her legs sitting on a piece of luggage. Like, just to prove that she's in a... I'm doing it for the podcast listeners.
And what does that mean to you?
I think that's totally fine for her to be like, I'm a...
She got that ass out, let me see.
To be like, I'm a...
You didn't tell me she had that ass out.
She's like, I'm a flight attendant.
Oh, she had British Airways. What's she about to do?
Nah, I don't know. I don't think that...
I think that you can have a regular job and have an OnlyFans. So I don't have a problem with you being like, I'm a stewardess. If that's what you want to sell for your storytelling, as long as you're an actual stewardess.
Can I hit you?
No.
Okay.
No. As long as you're an actual stewardess, as long as you're like, yo, for storytelling, I want to say I'm a stewardess. Like, I'm going to tell the truth. I'm a stewardess. That's my job. You might put that in your bio.
Yeah, but it would feel weird if you knew there was a guy who was on the plane that was only there to have sex with.
It might feel weird for oh, you mean he's in the other workers?
I don't know. I'm trying to think of just somebody who works.
The stewardess might be happy. She might be like, one of my clients here, one of my big clients is here. I wanted to meet him so bad. I told him to bring me 30,000. I just made 30,000.
Stop being jealous. Stop snitching on that.
You snitching.
Girl.
That's what I'm saying. That girl making her money, man.
I don't know. I'm not.
I don't think
I'm mad at sex workers having two jobs, you know?
It feels
like it keeps on coming back.
I'm definitely not mad at sex workers having two jobs.
It just matters to me if your sex work affects your other job. That's why I say that thing about the guy in the plane.
What do you mean?
Because I think you can keep it separate, because that might be unprofessional to mix two jobs. It's like bringing food that you bought at one restaurant into another restaurant.
Wait. You're saying you can't be a sex worker and a stewardess?
No, I'm saying that once your stewardess becomes your sex work office, then it's kind of like, I like that you work two jobs.
I don't think that
but
she
don't
could,
bring your work
no,
for that
I,
job
I'm
to
with
this
you, yeah.
job.
I don't think she could fuck in the bathroom.
Yeah, that's like, come on.
I mean, I want to fuck her in the bathroom, and I'll pay extra for that. But I also don't think she can, and I don't think it's smart.
Yeah, unless it's a lot of money involved. Don't just... What the fuck are you doing, Wrigley? You can't just tie up. Get off of me, dude.
Oh, whoa. He's so moved, mean to Wrigley. Everybody at home, because you guys think the dogs love him so much and he's so nice.
I have to.
He just threw. I hope we can show him throw Wrigley off the couch in slow motion. She almost lost her life. That was crazy.
I just can't have a
Wrigley, are you okay, Wrigley? Wrigley, are you okay, Mama? Wrigley, you okay? Oh, my Wriggles. I'm sorry, Wrigley. Oh, a hater is now coming over here. Going to try to rip Chris's cord out of his fucking head. Oh, you guys are just jealous of each other. That's all that happens.
Pilots use jet to draw penis in sky in support of masturbating footballer. Two pilots are under investigation for allegedly maneuvering their passenger jet through the air so that it drew the shape of a penis in the sky. The phallic-like turns were captured on flight tracking software and were apparently a bizarre act of solidarity with the Russian football team's captain. The unnamed crew of the Russian Pobeda airline are reported to have flown the plane so that it draw a penis to the country's team captain, Artem Dzyuba, who was suspended from international duty after footage showing him appearing to masturbate in bed was leaked online. The video highlights the alleged X-rated detour taken by flight DP-407 en route from Moscow to Yekaterinburg on November 11th. Kremlin-owned RT called it a ballsy flight path, but questioned whether the alleged stunt was a bit too cocky. Oh, God. This is probably the best way in which Pobeda captains expressed their support to Russian team captain Artem Dzyuba that showed their attitude to him being bullied, said a spokesman for the airline.
Are they in the Air Force for Russia?
I think they're just regular pilots.
They're just dudes.
I think they were like, we're going to be a little late getting to Orlando today.
We're going to do dick in support of sports captain.
It's also such a weird thing to fucking be in solidarity. Like, it's such a weird thing to be like, we're going to stand with you in your masturbating leak photo. What are you standing with him for? What are you saying? Like, we want to all be able to masturbate freely and record ourselves. What the fuck are you saying that you are behind?
The person they're standing against, they're being investigated, 32-year-old. Soccer player was blackmailed for $5 million over the compromising video, which was allegedly hacked from his mobile phone. The married player reportedly met a hacker responsible for stealing the intimate footage, but refused to pay the ransom.
And it's just footage of him masturbating?
So then it released?
Yeah, he released it. So what? You still didn't get your money. My dick's out. So what? But why did the pilots, why can't they just tweet?
Why
can't they just be like, yo, we think it's bullshit on Twitter?
Also, like, if you felt bad for a bunch of people blowing up this guy's dick pic, you just blew it up way bigger by making an international story.
And you drew his dick.
and you drew it with three balls, which was really weird.
A little disrespectful.
It is.
You kind of made his whole revenge porn thing like bigger. Like, now we know about it. We wouldn't have known about it before.
At all. That is crazy, man. Like, yeah. I mean, if somebody tries to blackmail you like that for $5 million off a fucking masturbation video, yeah, you don't fucking pay them. But it's also like the pilots are just really weird.
I don't understand what like what's up with in Russia. Like I feel like they're also a really homophobic culture, but they're also like, let's get behind this man and his masturbation video that was stolen from him. Like, are these the same guys? Are these
probably
are these guys who are against those guys who are so over the top that they kind of like. Like have overdone, like let's be free sexually and be like people should be able to have master. I mean, yes, that doesn't matter if this guy got a masturbation.
Oh,
because
he was fired from the team.
Oh, he was fired. Yeah. From the team.
He was fired.
He was
from
fired
the team.
So they were
the
protesting
after the
him
video.
Being fired
yes.
from the
for
team.
Masturbating.
Yeah.
Okay, that's an important.
That's
part.
Wild, fam. Now I'm with them. Draw more dicks. Shit.
Oh, so they're protesting the team.
That's, yes. Oh, that's trash team. You can't. What did the man do wrong? What did he do wrong? Can you not masturbate on camera?
You can't record yourself masturbating. Like what if you're in your job lines, it says, and you can't record yourself masturbating.
Very specific. Why would you say that? There's been people in the past.
We've learned that it needs to be in contracts. No, that one I believe.
What did he do wrong?
Even more so, this person is in the right than the last airline story, because but, like this has nothing to do with their job. They weren't in the middle of the goalposts masturbating. They weren't like.
How do you know that?
They don't. That the last sentence is just.
He came with the ball and kicked it. It was weird.
He like not, like broke into the stadium late at night and filmed himself masturbating.
No, but what did this dude do wrong? He didn't do anything
wrong. They're saying
wrong.
That they fired him to avoid negative publicity towards the end of the season because they need to prepare.
What does that even mean? He's the captain. Is he not the best player? Is he not one of the best players? He's the fucking captain, nonetheless.
Yeah, he's the captain, team captain.
Like, you're the captain. He's important. He's fucking important for him just to get kicked off the team for a masturbation.
His life matters.
No, it does, man. Because I'm really pissed off about this. A masturbation. How far is too far, cancel culture?
Do you guys want to watch the video?
No. What the fuck?
No.
I have it.
This, how'd you, what the, you're sick, Alana. Why'd you look up the video? Should he be fired?
He needs a raise.
What? Sick. I'm just confused on this cancel culture. We've gotten to a point where this man.
Well, Russia's cancer culture
is way behind ours.
It's in a different direction, too. Okay.
So they're kind of the same, though.
I think they're kind of like zip it up.
Zip it up?
See, as next week. No, I'm just kidding. No, I think they're like zippier. Like. I don't know. Are they? I feel like they're very sexually repressed in Russia. But are they, or are they fucking wild?
I know. I know they're wild. I know they're wild. I know they're wild.
I think they're wild.
I don't know how wild, though. I don't know, like, if it's. Yeah. I know they're wild, though.
Part of me feels like. You know how it must have felt to be, like, a European, like, landing in China, like, way, like, thousands of years ago? I wonder what the closest we have to that now is, because everybody's kind of so globalized. Part of me thinks just like Russia is so different in some far backwoods Russia places that they may not even like have a society like ours. I don't know. There are probably more places around the world than Russia, but am I just ranting? Yeah. Really? Come back to it.
Wrigley does. Oh, pops. Really, man?
What's up, baby?
I really let Nucky take over this spot. Shit.
What's up, girl?
Universal Studios Japan will open its Super Nintendo World area next year. The Universal Studios Japan theme park in Osaka will become its long-awaited Nintendo-themed area, which includes a Mario Kart ride, next year. As the official Twitter for the theme park revealed on Monday, Super Nintendo World is set to open on February 4th.
That's my birthday!
Yeah!
Fuck yeah!
You wanna go?
I would love to go to that.
I got you, bro. I'm gonna take you.
Wait, are you this year?
No. I got you, bro. Yeah, it's this
what?
Year.
It's yeah,
this year.
It's going to be unsafe, but I'm down.
You trying to be unsafe?
Will they let us in?
Hell yeah.
As Americans?
Bro, yes. We got big wine and weed fans in Japan.
We don't.
But we're speaking it into existence.
The area will launch with this Mario Kart ride that utilizes augmented reality headsets. To coincide with the announcement of the opening date, Universal Studios also shared a few images of what fans can expect to see when it opens. Bloomberg reporter Kirumi Mori detailed the Mario Kart attraction further on Twitter, revealing that it's called Koopa's Challenge and is inside Bowser's castle. While guests line up for the ride, they will be able to see more of the castle, which will be undoubtedly include many references to the Mario games.
I want a little live action play with the Mario Kart too, because when they did the Mario Kart in Japan, I think like a couple years back, when they were doing the Mario Kart in the streets, you could race in the streets and shit.
Yeah.
So you was drifting the little carts. They should have brought that to the actual theme park as well.
Do you think that would overwhelm, like, I love the idea of competition in the Mario video game, but then is it going to be a bunch of, like, kids versus, like, gamers, like, together in the Mario Kart line? And are they going to play well together? Is it going to become not fun?
That's what I'm saying. If you could, like, do, like, some kind of reality live action / like AR experience, or I mean VR experience, where you're driving. I'm good. Where you're driving, out there like with the actual Mario Karts. But then like if you get specials and stuff when you hit certain things, and you can press fake specials. And
it's got to be that, right?
Yeah, man.
Yeah. What? So what? Okay, I'm very excited about it. I think Mario Kart game is a great first game, and I'm wondering, like, what do you mean Mario Kart game? Where are you going to put me? Are you putting me in Bowser's Castle? Do I have to ride Mario Karts through Bowser's Castle? Because, like, they're just choosing Bowser's Castle? Really? What would your Mario Kart level that you think would make the best ride be?
Ooh.
Are you going to? I think you could have a Mario Kart world.
Ooh.
You could have a Mario Kart world. You could have DK's Jungle Parkway over here. You could have Rainbow Road up there. You could
like Rainbow Road.
Do
I like,
fucking
Peaches. I like Peaches. Is it Peaches? No, it's not Peaches Castle. What is it?
I think it's Peaches. Peaches.
Peaches Castle, I think, Peaches right? Castle? Yeah, I like Peaches Castle. It makes me feel loved.
Yeah, that big launch at
the
end.
But I will add that the whole ride is completely just AR.
Yeah, we know.
The whole ride is completely AR. Those always kind of disappoint me a little bit, if I'm being honest.
Yeah. Yeah, Peach's Castle.
But that's what Universal Studios is doing now. All of their rides are like connected VR. It's like the VR plus movement. Do you like those rides?
What, the ones that...
VR plus movement? I think they're cool ideas, but it's not the same.
I still like, I'm still old-fashioned guys in a lot of ways, you know?
Give me some Mario Kart
sometimes
coasters.
I feel fucking old, man. Sometimes I feel old. Do you ever do things that make you feel old, Chris? What's the oldest thing you do right now? Like, what's the oldest thing consistently that either you do or that's happening to you? It's like, what the fuck? You ever just get up and, like, something just hurt?
My back hurting.
You just be like, what the fuck is going on, right?
Yeah, it's also just like my back hurts all the time. And it's like, ah, my back, like judging the level of hurtness your back is today.
Yeah.
That's not fun.
Yeah, it's not fun.
No.
Anything else that you're just like, what the fuck?
Nah, it's all just aches and cranes. And I'm starting to realize, and I think I played it right in my life, but I'm starting to realize that I can't fucking eat everything. Can't eat everything anymore.
Yeah, I just got mad at my girlfriend.
You're gonna feel shitty.
Got mad at my girlfriend. I said, yo. I don't care what you eat. Stop putting that shit on me. I don't like this horrible food. She orders like Taco Bell and all type of wild.
My girlfriend
disgusting
has
shit.
A milkshake every single night and oftentimes in the morning as well.
What the fuck?
And she's How's she living? Skinny as fuck. I don't know how
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. Like, I can't be doing that with you. I can't be.
I know. I take a fucking sip and then I'm one quarantine later, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
But she's just like, yeah, I'm drinking two milkshakes a day. I can't.
Two milkshakes a day. Also, she's mad.
No, I don't know how she does it.
Yeah, yeah. I can't.
It's kind of rude.
I can't, like.
It's kind of fucking
rude. You know
what
I do? My thing that fucks me up is that I'll eat Flamin' Hots late night. Ooh. I'll get high and eat Flamin' Hots late night. And then you wake up and think you got ass cancer. Because your asshole is just, bloody. It's not bloody for real, but it might as well be because you're looking at Flamin' Hot.
Hot chicken sandwiches.
Yeah, you're just like, this is just fucking all red because the fucking process, the dye and shit. I shouldn't be eating this shit no more. I'm a grown ass man. It's time for me to grow the fuck up. That's what I tell myself.
It's like a food hangover. It's like you can get hangover without drinking anything, just eating cheese.
Real shit, man. You're like, yeah. I just don't feel good.
I think that's where I'm there. That's where I'm at. So I think I got to start, you know, it's like, it's been a good run though. I'm glad I didn't get all healthy when I was like 23 and I was like, I'm going to eat clean.
I've been working out right now again.
I did every once in a while. Yeah. Congrats. That's great.
I'm trying to get right. You know what I'm saying? I got the gym set.
That's active. That's
in the house now. You know what I'm saying? You want to pull up and get this work, man.
I know. I got to jump in. Cause every once in a while, I pick up your weights, and I'm like, oh, yeah, the gym. Remember what that was?
The gym.
Sperm donor under investigation after fathering 23 children in a year.
That was interesting. That was interesting. In 1 year?
Wait, let me hear that.
In 1 year?
I gotta hear it.
Australia's most prolific sperm donor who fathered 23 children in 1 year is investigated by authorities after his hobby turned into a full-time job because mums love his ethnicity and strike rate. Brisbane sperm donor Alan Fan, 40, has fathered 23 children in just 1 year. Donors who give to fertility clinics are supposed to only create 10 new families. Mr. Fan said he knew he had reached his limit, but his sperm was in high demand. Alan Fan, who has two children of his own, has been privately providing sperm to would-be parents as well as donating through registered fertility clinics. The 40-year-old man from Brisbane is being investigated by the Victorian Assisted Reproductive Authority, which manages the state's donor registers. Several clinics told the authority that Mr. Fan had been donating sperm outside the registers and might have helped create more children for others than is permitted. Under Victorian law, men can only create 10 families, including their own. Mr. Fan said he found it very hard to turn women down, knowing how desperate they were to have a baby and had donated to 3 women in 1 day. When I first started, I was going to donate 9 times, he said. I reached my 9th and I thought that was it. Then I received a message from a lady around Christmas saying the donation was successful, which became my 10th. I thought, well, I've already gone over my limit. I'll just help a few more.
Line up!
Like a full-time job. He had to abstain from sexual activity, work out at the gym daily, and take plethora of vitamins to ensure healthy sperm.
How much money he get from this? How much bread he take in for 23 bodies he got? 23 kids in 1 year? That's wild. How many kids do you have all together?
This is a Vince Vaughn movie, right?
Yeah, it is. It is a Vince Vaughn movie.
Okay, just
except for the fucking real crazier version.
Yeah, this actually happened.
Yeah, and he ain't got to take care of nobody, right? It's crazy.
I don't think so. I mean,
you don't have to take care of nobody?
What? My thing is that, like, did 53 of these people, were they like, I don't know, he looks good? Or were they like,
no, his success rate. His success rate. So they say because ethnicity. So the women want to make sure that they go into a donor more than likely because they, well, I don't know if that's the reason, but they want to make sure it also works. And they want to pick their sperm that they get. So
he's
said,
fertile.
He said, So he said his nut is working, first of all. So his success rate is like high. So women have wanted his sperm. And then also he said he's Vietnamese. And I don't know where he is, but it must
be. It's in Australia.
Australia. So he's like, also my ethnicity. Women was trying to get a little mix up.
Was he selling himself, or did it just happen that like 58 people were like, let's do this?
It's
like,
23.
I don't know. There's something feels sociopathic. 23? Mm-hmm. That's still a lot.
In 1 year.
Something feels sociopathic about him.
I think he is definitely a fucking maniac.
I think he's a total sociopath. Person.
But I'm also like, is he doing, again, we go back to the space of, is he doing anything illegal? Is this illegal? He went over his limit.
No, I'm just surprised 23 women have the judgment to breed with the sociopath.
Are you?
Wow, diss on Australian woman.
No, it's just, I just think people are crazy in general.
Yeah, of course.
So I just think that it makes sense that, like, people were like, yeah, his success rate is cool, and he's Vietnamese in Australia.
Looks
so
hot.
So I need to see.
I want my son to be hot, high education. Sociopath?
Yeah.
I'm in.
He's got 23 kids, though, now. 1 year.
And did he have zero kids before that? How old is he?
He only had two kids of his own.
He got 25 kids.
What do you feel?
Oh, he got two actual kids.
Wow, how would you feel as well?
He has two actual kids. Now, if you're those kids, you think he's kind of cool.
You're like, you think your cool, dad's got like, a whole dad, bunch of. Why weren't we good enough? Why do you need to?
No, you think like my dad has a whole bunch of other fucking fake kids.
What if you're the mom? What if you're the mom? Like, why would you be like, why is Ken doing this? Why is he spreading his seed around? This is a full time job, Ken. You need to raise our children.
It's not their business.
He's like, my cum means something.
I think you're confused. He's raising their children. He doesn't. He's just coming real quick, dude.
I don't think it's real quick. I think it's a full time.
He said it was a full time. It felt like a full time job.
It felt like a full time job.
And he has to abstain from
sex. He has to abstain from sex.
He said he has sex. So his wife isn't getting anything.
Yeah, that probably feels great to be his wife.
What do you mean?
He said he has to abstain from sexual activity.
He has to.
For 23 nuts, he needs 365 days.
This is like a really weird way to not have an affair. It kind of feels like. Like he I mean, I don't want to put something in these kids' head. You know, I know they watch Wine and Weed. but I just think it's a little bit, a little sus.
No, I mean, I don't think as long as he's not trying to stay in those kids' lives or contacting the women, I guess all the women know who he is. He's got fucking articles with his name in it. So they all know who he is. It's not like, a mystery. So we know exactly who he is, which means they probably know his IG or where he stays. He's probably still fucking these women. He might be fucking them, too.
I mean, yeah, he might be. This might be.
With private sperm clinics, which he's donating to, he can pick who receives his sperm. So he knows who the women are.
Oh, he is for sure fucking them.
He has a weird. So basically, so
the women are choosing your nut, and you don't think they will.
This is why I said it's borderline cheating, because he's basically Tinder swiping on women he wants to have children with, while his wife's sitting next to him being like, "Why aren't you around for our kids?" He's like, "Cause I got a nut and give these women babies."
And, no, he has to make money for the family.
And she's like, "Can we make love?" And he's like, "No, I gotta make kids."
You're not asking
the family.
You're not asking the right questions. What is he good at? He might be good at busting nuts, Chris. That might be his.
Well, that's what she might miss.
That might be what she missed.
That's his talent.
But he has to provide for the family one way or another. He might for him. He's saying,
it's Corona.
Yo, fam, Alana, how much is he making? Per nut.
It doesn't say how much.
But a lot, I can guarantee that much. A lot. A whole fucking lot. And he hidden. And his success rate is crazy. Bro, he probably got out of those 23 kids, he probably made at least like 150 racks in the year. No?
23 kids. I mean, I don't think you make that type of money slinging sperm. I think you make that kind of money with eggs.
No. If you're a person that is known for slinging sperm,
okay,
and you're giving out certain kids, he might be hella smart too.
Oh, well, what's up with his kids? Why doesn't he?
Men are paid anywhere from $35 to $125 per donation.
How much is a woman paid for an egg? Ooh. I totally get that it's a much, much, much more complicated process.
$35.
Sometimes you hear
women are paid anywhere between $8,000 to $14,000
for
it. Wait, yeah. Fam,
that's
fam,
what you're thinking.
Fam,
you're not fam, thinking fam, about sperm.
No, I am. Because he said he Vietnamese in Australia. He got some motherfucking rare sperm. But I also think it's hilarious that in my head, also, he is making $35 per nut. And he's selling her. Bitch, this is a full-time job. I need you to let me focus.
I got to work out. I got to masturbate every once in a while. It's not that much. I gotta eat right. I gotta work out.
Yeah,
I was not a
man. I think
maybe he is a good dad.
I think he's getting like $5,000 at least minimum.
And maybe he's busy being a good dad and jacking off. And
yeah, I think he's a good dad for sure.
Between those two things, he feels like he doesn't have time for a job.
To be a footballer.
So he calls it a full-time job. To be a footballer.
What's it called, man?
Yeah, I got caught on tape masturbating.
Yeah.
Oh, that footballer making an extra $35.
Oh. Hey, Nucky. The dogs are with me this week, guys.
The one
seems funny. Who?
The virtual girlfriend.
The virtual girlfriend? Would you get a virtual girlfriend? Like, if you were single during the beginning of quarantine till now, would you have your girlfriend that was maybe just a virtual girlfriend? Or a girlfriend that was just maybe like across the country that you was like, you know what, fuck it, I can't see anybody anyway. I'm really hitting it off with this girl who lives in Louisiana.
I'm pretty sure those are two very different things.
I don't care.
Right? Well, I could totally understand the girl who lives in Louisiana. I don't quite understand the virtual girlfriend.
Why not?
I'm surprised we can't meet enough other human beings.
People are awkward.
I don't know. Yeah, I
people
guess
people are awkward,
so.
Dude.
That's
I think
so
you're giving.
Unfortunate.
Why is that unfortunate? Because
I want people to experience the magic of connecting with another human being.
Oh, you think you're so fucking cool, Chris?
No, wait, I think everybody has done it and can do it. Except,
huh?
This article is actually quite interesting.
Virtual girlfriend app points the way to sci-fi future of online clubs and festivals. A new app that uses artificial intelligence to blend augmented reality and virtual reality can create real people inside your phone or even send you back in time. Blade Runner-style virtual friends have become a reality long before the sci-fi movie predicted it. Hybrid uses of a combination of augmented reality, virtual reality, and artificial intelligence to put a convincing 3D companion in your home, ideal for those of us feeling a bit isolated in lockdown. The unique project, first reported by the Daily Star in June, is now live on Kickstarter and will soon be shipping. It promises the ability to create your perfect partner in interactive 3D without the need for additional VR wands or gloves. Models can either be photorealistic using Hybrid's photo upload option to create a 3D model of a real human being or based on an anime template. Environments as well as people can be recreated too in the app's new time travel function that lets users step back in time to a favorite holiday or other treasured memory.
So this is her. Yeah. So this is just her.
Is it just her?
Yeah. Do we like? Do you like this? Do you want a weird companion? Can you have a girlfriend and a companion, a virtual girlfriend? Like, you think it's gonna become normal for a girlfriend to let you have a virtual girlfriend? What if you have your real problems with your girlfriend? You get to go talk to your virtual girlfriend about your problems. You get to talk them out, and she may help you understand shit. You're like, damn, virtual girlfriend, thank you. Also,
wow.
How do you open that virtual mouth? Some virtual neck.
Like, everyone's allowed a virtual mistress.
Yeah.
Because it stops people from cheating.
Yeah.
But you know what people are going to do? Cheat on their virtual mistress.
You think so? No. With another virtual mistress?
I think.
Imagine you go to somebody else's house and his virtual mistress is looking at you all crazy.
You show me a hot virtual mistress and I'll show you a guy who's tired of
That's what I'm saying. Do you think we need virtual mistresses?
I wish we didn't. I
just have to go back to it real quick because I was like, that could solve so much.
I guess so. And
I think also for people who didn't have mistresses, they just have virtual girlfriends as well.
I don't know about the thing in addition to a relationship. I don't know. I haven't thought about it.
I think in addition to a relationship, it's cool because it helps you talk things out. It helps you virtually come.
It feels like it's suddenly emotional cheating when you have a virtual mistress. Even though, but there's no one
how
on the other side of it.
How emotional are you really going to get?
There's no one on the other side of it.
Yeah, and if your girl really gets jealous of some computer.
That's a great argument against it, is that there's literally no one on the other side of it.
If you really get jealous of this computer,
these are the conversations we're going to have in the relationships of our lives. There's nobody on this other side of it.
Almost
just
threw
up. She's a computer. And then your virtual girlfriend's like, am I just a computer? You're like, I didn't mean that. You're not just a computer to me. Guess what? I've been recording your conversations with her thanks to a new app, and you told her you're not just a girlfriend to me. She's a robot. She's a fucking robot.
It's going to be all good until you see your girl cheating on you with her virtual boyfriend. So we never brought up virtual boyfriends.
Oh, I didn't
virtual boyfriends. Because they can do what they want with those virtual boyfriends.
Oh, shit. Wow. Wow, would that turn it around all
turn
of a sudden.
Turn it around. Shut this thing down. Unplug
no
this
technology in this house.
Unplug this nigga.
Got it. A guy would flip on a
We
dime.
Won't live like the Amish in this motherfucker.
The new technology was bad. There's no one on the other side of it, though. But there's no one.
Yeah,
I wouldn't
care if my girlfriend had a virtual boyfriend. I'd be like,
it's like cool.
I'd be like, so cool. I would probably talk to him sometimes and be like, yo, make sure she's happy. Like, when she's getting on my nerves, please get her attention. Like, you please take her off my hands. Me and him would probably be friends. I'd be like, nigga, you cool as fuck, bro.
She's like, so I actually think I might just get uploaded and be with Daryl.
Why is his name Daryl? Out of all the names of my, and her virtual boyfriend, his name's Daryl.
I don't know. I just picked her
name. I'm joking. If she did that, I would look her dead in the face and say, look, do you love Daryl? Do you love Daryl?
I also see Daryl spelled with a 4, so it's like D 4.
Oh, it's pretty cool. It's cool, yeah. It's cool.
Yeah.
Oh, it's about Claudia. If Claudia got a virtual boyfriend, like, would you be like, that's crazy? Would you be like, that's cool?
I would be curious about the need for a virtual boyfriend.
What if she was like talking to him about y'all? Just how about you don't how you
well,
don't listen?
That's why
to
I'm asking. Well, what? So she has like a virtual therapist boyfriend?
Well, I mean, her virtual boyfriend, he is definitely giving a virtual dick, but he also
she's also getting dick from him. How does that work?
You're fucking your virtual girlfriend.
I'm masturbating while watching my virtual
same thing.
Girlfriend.
I'm sorry. Same
so
thing.
She's masturbating while watching her therapist boyfriend.
He has a vibrator. He controls it.
The cloud controls it, like
yeah.
Some VR controls yeah. it. I don't like it, but because now I have theory. Now I'm like afraid about it, like who's controlling the virtual boyfriend program.
Nobody's on that other side.
They're probably paying a lot of money. There probably is someone on the other side, babe.
There is nobody on the other side.
Sounds like there is.
Okay. No, I mean, I'm all for virtual girlfriends. I think we need them. I think it's the smartest thing that would be brought up on this show, and that it can help us with a lot of problems. Yeah, ever. It can help. It can help people who have like these sexual fucking, you know, problems and shit not have those problems. They have virtual girlfriends. They have the companionship, and they be like, oh shit. I think you gotta figure out a way to really like do a collaboration with like Fleshlight. Or somebody just still get the real for sure.
I'm sure. Pull
your
bang a bang. That thought.
Yeah, your bang a bang, and also same thing. I think the vibrator is needed for the woman. I think you have to be able to conquer both sides. But if you can communicate and talk to and just enjoy watching a movie with your virtual girlfriend, because she gotta like what you like.
So let's fast forward. It's like 10 years later. Your girl's had a virtual boyfriend for like a while. For like. Yeah. And now it's like he virtually proposes. There's this new program where now like somebody on the other end is actually controlling it, and you never meet that person. They work in a factory, are you now a little bit more like, I don't like that somebody out there is seeing this? Or are you like, as long as there's no contact and we don't know this person in a real way?
I would be confused on how technology has went backwards. Well, now we need some person to control this.
You're like, what are you talking about, man? Yeah, I don't know. It's just this guy controls it.
Why?
Never mind. I have a different question. Come on, give me the next question. That one didn't well. It's because I wanted to. All right, here we go. So my question is, when you're old, to mm-hmm. bring it back to getting old,
mm-hmm.
because sometimes I think about how when I'm really old, it's going to be kind of like sad and terrible.
But funny.
You know?
It'll be funny. I think I make myself laugh at all times, just off the strength of like, damn, I'm going to die.
Yeah.
That's some funny shit. I live a life. This is crazy.
Yeah, you think it's funny, but then sometimes you're with like an old person, they make those jokes, and you're like, hey, that's real. Stop.
But they live life. I love the people. Yeah.
But sometimes it's sad. But like, do you think that there's a place, and I'll continue to push your
perpetual
idea
girlfriend?
Of consciousness? Yeah. For at one point you go, well, I can't fucking stand anymore. So I'd rather exist in the world of my virtual girlfriend. And now it's not just a virtual girlfriend.
Oh, you want to put me in the virtual world?
No, I'm saying that maybe there's a whole virtual world. Right now we're at the first Nintendo theme park, but it's only 2020. We're talking about 2050. We're increasing exponentially. Mm-hmm. You could be in a different place. You could feel like you're using your legs
mm-hmm.
if you just upload your consciousness to the cloud.
Yeah.
Will you ever do it?
Oh, so my legs don't work anymore.
Yeah, let's say not.
Why? What happened?
muscular deterioration. Sometimes shit comes out of nowhere, man.
Yeah, man. On both my legs.
It was a sad day. You wrote a book.
Fucking superior.
You wrote
athlete,
a book about
man.
It, and you did a wheelchair tour, and it was like really successful.
All right, I'll take it.
Yeah.
You know how to get to me. that happens. Do I upload my body and my fucking brain to the cloud and I become?
I'm saying now that you're like, you lost those legs and did that tour when you were like 55.
Yeah.
You did it in the 40s. That was your wheelchair tour years, the 40s.
Yeah.
But now it's the 60s, it's the 70s, it's even almost the 2080s. And like, your body's deteriorating. It hurts to be in your body.
Mm-hmm.
If you could upload to the cloud, you could relive memories. You could go.
How long? How long do I live?
As
like
long,
that?
It's like playing video games. You can put it on for as long as you want and just disappear into the cloud.
So I never die, or do I die as soon as I go into the cloud?
What, like, does your body stay here?
My natural body.
You're in a vegetative
Do I die
state.
As soon as I go into the cloud?
You're in a vegetative state.
So I die as soon as I go to the cloud.
You're in a vegetative state.
No, well, who's going to pay for that? Who's going to keep all these bodies over the years?
Your book sales for the wheelchair book is going to pay for it.
No. That money's going to run out.
How much money are you spending?
I couldn't move my legs. I had a drinking problem.
Okay. You said that much money on it?
Yeah. Johnny Depp money. $1 million a month.
Oh, man.
On wine.
Yeah, see, this is why you want to go relive it in the cloud.
I don't know, man. I don't know about that. I think that what were we saying again? P. That Ricky's been just playing here. My dogs love me. See,
I'm just wondering.
The people in the comments say what they say. The dogs don't like you. Sterling ain't like Chris. Bullshit. The dogs are here tonight.
Fuck.
If I get up right now and I'm gonna pee and come back, they will be gone.
You don't think that, and I don't know if this is true. So, if my grandkids are watching this in the future, don't take this as like proof. I want to like make sure I think this out a little more. This is the first time I thought about this.
Uh-oh.
But like, you don't think when you're older, there may be an inclination to like, you don't think when we're old, we're like in retirement, we're not going to play video games? Like way more than old people now.
Yeah, we probably will. Yeah,
way more. We're gonna know. This is gonna be like PlayStation 40. It's gonna be like amazing. It's gonna be this whole body thing. You're gonna feel like you're in the different existence. And I think we might just become like obsessed with it. And
What's wrong with that?
Nursing sounds of the future may basically be like living in virtual reality.
Oh, that's cool. You hate it.
No, I'm curious. What do you want you're the one who usually says that you don't want the brain chip and you don't want the upload.
I don't want the fucking brain chip. I'm not getting the brain chip. I'm not uploading shit. Not uploading shit, Chris. I'm never getting me like that.
Well, that's I was not sure if you would be into this idea of reality. I think I framed it.
I won't be in a fucking nursing home. I'm gonna die at home.
And you don't want to play. If your body is aching, and you can put on this mind mask, and you are transported to a different virtual reality where you don't feel the pain that you feel in this life, you wouldn't like fuck with it.
I'm saying that if they have that, I'm not gonna be in no nursing home with my shit.
Yeah, that's fine. But are you going to do that? Are you gonna upload yourself? Or let's say that's not a permanent thing. You don't have to choose here or there. You can just put this mind mask on and hit that virtual reality.
What do you mean mind mask?
Like, I imagine that it's just like a VR mask, really.
A little VR mask. It's just the more advanced version of VR fucking goggles right now.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. You say I can just throw these shits on and what, be the young me again, live out my old memories.
If you want, or you could also, there's like a Spider-Man game.
Okay, a Spider-Man game. There or can go. I like put my, can I live out like my old memories in a new game version where I do things differently than I did in the past?
I'd say yes.
That's fun.
Yeah, that sounds fun.
That's fucking fun.
And it's like you get to control your dreams kind of thing.
Yeah, and like you could really go back and see about that girl in high school that you thought like, what would life be like if I married her? And marry her and just see what life would be like.
And then you're like, okay, I died. You go back to the beginning.
No, I'm just saying, like, if you can go and just see your different outcomes from doing different things, that'd be cool.
But would you trust it, or do you think it was just doing an algorithm?
I would like it either way.
You just think it was interesting?
Yeah, I'd be like, I guess they could look that way.
But don't you think they took that info from your mind? So in a way, you're letting them into your mind by letting them.
Hey, man, I'm old as fuck.
Okay, well, this is what I'm really getting at. Is that
if I'm like, if I'm like 90,
when we're like in our 90s,
if I'm fucking 90, who cares?
Are we just?
I'm happy I'm not. I'm happy I'm not pooping myself.
Would you slowly get uploaded instead of experience death?
What do you mean? What the fuck is the question?
Like, one way you die and the other way you just upload it and then your body dies.
Upload it. They're like, I'm your being soul, pixelated going soul, into the sky.
Your soul leaves Ralph your body. Style. Oh, I just imagine you going to a USB drive. That's like stuck
I'm
into
turning into like Ant-Man size and get into a USB drive?
Yeah, I think your soul is put into a USB drive, basically.
Versus what? Going to heaven and hell?
And then you're locked into this world. And then I think the way that it would collide with this, and you'd basically cruise in virtual reality world until your soul, basically until the place you would have died anyway, right? If you were going to die in 6 days, you could have been uploaded anyway. And when your body dies, your soul goes from the uploaded world to heaven, I think. I think that's how it would collide with your view of heaven.
Yes, okay.
You know, because your body still lives until it doesn't anymore. Okay. But you're uploaded, and then I don't know if your soul lives in there or if it moves on. Or maybe your soul was in the body the whole time.
Oh, what if we can just, like...
I think it's kind of two different systems.
We can decide to, freeze our body, but upload our brains, and then our brains continue to advance. But we have the same body. That we keep a body at a certain age. We say, I want this body...
Okay.
Everything.
Then you freeze the body.
But yeah, but my brain continues to go until I'm 85. And you still die. You shut down at a certain time.
Wait.
Your brain still shuts down at a certain time, but your body, you get to still function in the body.
The body lives, right, because it's frozen or it's preserved.
You're in the body still. I'm just at the freezing.
Your soul's in the body or your mind's in the body?
I was saying you're like pausing the fucking body in a certain
way. Yeah, right. I see that. And then it's arguable whether the soul goes with the mind or stays in the body.
The mind is in the body.
I thought the mind was in the cloud.
No, okay. Okay. I was asking a different question.
Oh, okay. I thought you uploaded your mind and froze your body.
Maybe I said that. I meant like, yeah, keep my mind though where it continues to develop and I continue to get wiser and smarter and all that stuff. but I get to keep a certain body. But at a certain
age. You're in a virtual world when you were developing your mind, right?
No, it's kind of like the worlds collide.
I don't know where the mind went.
It's okay. Listen.
I thought I was with you.
It's very simple. I got you. It's me saying, Steelo, I'm going to keep my body at the age of 32, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to keep this body.
You upload your mind?
No, I upload my mind. Yes, okay. I upload my mind.
And you freeze the body. And in your mind,
I just keep this body. I'm functioning with this body. I'm behaving with this body. I'm living my life with this body. But my mind is continuing to develop, get more wise. And as my mind continues to go on, just as sometimes the brain and the heart whatever shuts down, my brain will shut down at a certain point. So I still die.
This just sounds like life. I don't understand how the computer's involved.
What are you talking about?
Wait.
I get to keep the body is my, how the fuck
you But how do you preserve the body? There's no freezing?
It does. Yeah, I said we freeze it to stay at a certain age, but I also was just speaking of technology going forward. I wasn't speaking like
you
this.
You're saying that I don't want to move my mind to a different world. I want my body to be just like my old one in this world. Right?
What the fuck, man? Let's say it again.
You're saying that you don't want your mind to go into a virtual reality world. You would rather the advancements in technology help your current body be like your old one.
Yes.
But I don't know if we'll ever, you think we'll ever figure that out?
I don't know. I was just making up a different fucking world, man.
Yeah, that they'll actually help us in this world. We get to stay here. I don't think so. I think people are going to leave.
People are gonna leave.
They're gonna wally up.
You think people are gonna figure out? You think like Elon Musk in like 30 years is gonna have a whole different? You think he's gonna be like Mars? I own it now. I bought Mars. We live there. There is civilization there. You guys can move to Mars. I am the president, Elon Musk. This is my vice president, of course, Kanye West.
Do you think Elon Musk would like living on Mars?
I don't know, but I can see Elon Musk being like, I own Mars and I'm still a citizen in America. I come back and shit.
Yeah. I feel like Elon would like send somebody to space, like Kanye. So he's like, Kanye is the president.
You think he would give Kanye Mars?
Me. I'm going to stay here. Kanye, do your thing.
Kanye would say he was richer than Elon. Elon is now the second richest person on Earth, right?
Wow.
That's insane. Wow. On Earth. That always sounds like crazy.
Hey, do you think it would have been appropriate for me to request that Elon pay for my brunch when I saw him just because he's the second largest person on Earth?
He's the second largest person.
Richest person on Earth. He's just a huge person. He's like,
humongous.
He looks the same as he does, but he's like the size of Andre the Giant.
Yeah.
Can you ask? All right, because like... I know you can't just ask a random rich person, but like if your thing is that you're the richest person on Earth, like Bill Gates should pay for your meal if you ask, right?
No.
It should be like
get your hand out that man pocket.
Now I gotta pay for your meal.
Get your hand
no,
out that man
No, it's like you're
pocket.
The richest person in the
Get
world.
Get your hand
That's
out
That's funny.
That
you spotted
pocket.
Me. I'll pay for your meal.
Get your man.
That's
Get your
if
hand.
I was this when I'm the second richest person in the world. I'm going to do that for anyone who goes, Chris, I see you. You got to pay for my meal.
Bro.
I'll go, you got me.
Yeah, okay, that's your thing. That's your thing that you want to do with your money. Bill Gates has the right to not pay for your motherfucking meal. He got the right to be at McDonald's, seeing you ordering a dollar menu, and you patting your pockets for fucking 3 cents, and they won't let you get away with it. And him shrugging his shoulders when you turn around.
And rolling up $100 bill as a cigarette and lighting it on fire.
Lighting it on fire for no reason. He ain't even smoking anything inside of it.
He just lit it and stared you down.
Yeah.
He has the right to do that.
He has the right to do that.
But I think it would be funnier. And I still
it
say
it seems like
this
you benefit from this. It feels like you're going to just stop Bill Gates.
I still say at this level, there's something that this country, I don't know if I've said on this show before, but I think that they're the top 1%, when you file your taxes, you should get a wristband that you get to wear that's really fancy. That's like, I'm in the top 1%. and then you get access to fucking things in airplanes and shit, and then make it a status symbol, and then people would be proud of the big taxes they pay in the top 1%. And I'm sorry, you also raise the taxes really high in the top 1% because people would be so proud that they were there that they wouldn't mind paying the taxes as much.
Nah, people still like money.
Yeah, but then they would go, I don't care if I have the fucking band or not. I avoided the taxes.
Yeah, they would still like money, yeah.
I think it'd be nice to like...
It would be cool, though.
Give a bracelet that people know is like, I pay some of the most taxes in the world. And we go like, we view that as a virtue. You pay a lot of taxes. That's really cool. But then you have
niggas out here with fake bracelets on the internet. Fucking.
I pay a lot of taxes. Motherfucking
shining and shit.
I pay a lot of taxes. All the rappers in
the fucking internet with their fake bracelets on.
A lot of taxes.
My shit real, though. I don't know about none of your niggas. My shit real, fam. I pay hella taxes, fam. Ask about me. Taxpayer.
Taxpayer.
That'd be a rapper's name for sure. Taxpayer.
Taxpayer.
Why are you doing this deep?
Taxpayer. It's Saxophone Jones.
Saxophone Jones.
Saxophone Jones.
Saxophone Jones. Saxophone Jones. Yo, man, you know people say in the comments, Chris? People say I be bullying you. They said, black people, stop bullying Chris on this show. Let me tell all you motherfuckers one thing.
Black people?
Or they said me and Sam last week were bullying you together. It was hard to watch.
You thought, did they say that? I liked how you took that conversation.
Yeah, those the ones you read. But
I didn't see
I think
a lot
also
of
they don't fucking bullying. Realize our relationship. My job is to bully Chris on his whiteness so he can carry it out to the other whites and let them know about the things that they're doing wrong. It works well, believe me.
Well, Chris, I hope I also...
Chris is like the Harriet Tubman of white men.
Well,
he
sometimes
has saved
I also
so
ask
many white
things
men.
That white people ask me that
on purpose.
I already
yes.
maybe know the answer to, and I take that beating like Jesus did.
Whoa.
What?
Didn't think that was going to be where you went.
No, but I do... Because honestly, I think... And then you, I like that I have the permission to also say those things that white people sometimes go like, okay, never mind, thank you.
No,
okay,
I
I'll think what I think and I walk away.
My favorite part about you, Chris, is that you're purely white, man, and I love you for it because you don't try to be anything that you're not. You try to be exactly what you are, and you try to be understanding and exactly who you are, and that's what's cool to me. Like, you know, you get white dudes who are like, yeah, I know black culture, and you're like, yo, I don't know everything. I know some things. I grew up around some people, but not really a lot of black people, so teach me. I'm open to it. That's what it takes to actually have true progression. So that's why I fuck with you, because you've never tried to present yourself as anything but Chris Reinecker, but as a dude from Central Coast of California, and as a dude that like is a Trump supporter. You've only been truly what you are.
No, I feel like all these conversations. I was just thinking before the show. I was like, oh, the last 3 weeks is true. Have been very. There is Akon's country. And then there was the idea of these like the Black Confederacy or not mm-hmm. the Black Confederacy, the Digital Confederacy. Mm-hmm. And then that idea transferring to digital communities in that way. And then last week, obviously, was Sam. The race war. No, race but like fun. It was super fun. And I mean, super fun. I killed my dad. It was no, but I don't know. I think I've always viewed it as just a conversation. Don't take it personally.
It's a great exactly. But no,
and
I just said that because in my head I was like,
and it's true and it's interesting and it's wild and I don't like it always about white people.
That'd be the best part.
Not that, you know, white people have also done great things. Look, whites. I'm not talking total shit.
Talk about the good things y'all did.
With flew planes.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
We did some planes. A lot of us killed the Nazis. Some of us were.
Fuck yeah.
We're the Nazis.
Y'all found America?
We founded them. like the ideas behind America had some good ideas, and a lot of people like killed the natives, and I think a lot of people didn't ask questions.
No, they had good ideas.
But I liked all the Age of Enlightenment stuff was dope. The Age of Industry was really cool. That was a lot of good stuff. Yeah, there's a lot of like labor exploitation, sure, but that's what we do. Yeah. We exploit labor. No, but like,
y'all do some other good shit.
Yeah, I think we've done.
Sometimes
some good
I told you. Sometimes I watch white movies. It just be like a white movie, and I'm like, damn, it's a good ass white movie.
Ooh, there's some good ass white. I love.
It's
good
so
ass
cool
white
these
music.
White motherfuckers do like this cool ass like white shit. Quentin Tarantino will throw a white film together, and I love it. I'd be like, this is fucking cool. And Glorious Bastards, I watched again recently, and I was like, this is fucking dope.
Yeah, we got like.
Once upon a time in Hollywood.
Yeah, we got like hippie free love movement. You know, that's a real
that
white
shit
thing.
Was cool. That's some real white shit, yeah.
That shit was
I
cool.
Realized we recently that hippies were just rich kids that ran away from home.
Rich. What were they? Kids of the 50s, right?
Rich in spirit.
Yeah,
man.
You know what they are? There are a lot of kids of the 50s. They're those kids from.
They just ran away from home.
Yeah.
They were like, Mom, you don't get it.
Yeah.
Peace, love.
Yeah.
And weed.
Yeah, and LSD.
And LSD, and they were like leaving this shit. They were just badass rich kids that didn't listen to their parents.
That's pretty cool. So, oh man, I know now.
Name one black hippie that you know.
Jimi Hendrix.
No, well, he might be the only one.
Bob Marley.
No, Rasta.
Oh, you're saying he's not a hippie?
Like, there are no black hippies. They don't exist. And I realized recently, hippies are just white kids that ran away from home.
No, there's...
Name them.
They're fucking these dudes. Big
Name
afros.
Name them. No, bro. That was Jimmy just fucking
just
white bitches.
Jimmy
he was sneaking in real quick with the tequila.
No, there's some fucking black hippies. You're saying that the most...
Yeah, Kendrick and fucking
no,
Schoolboy
Q. No, there's no way. There's no way there's not... Are you saying Jimi Hendrix is the only black dude that played at Woodstock?
Black hippies, bro, in the 60s. Here we go. I'm clicking it. Who?
No,
we think you guys are amazing. I'm drunk. Yeah. We love you guys. You guys are amazing. I'll try to be nicer to Chris. I really will. I don't hate Chris at all. He's one of my best friends. And, like, I thought that you guys got that through our sense of humor. But now that you guys don't, I'll soften up. You fucking punk. Ass bitches.
Were you like going through this whole episode like don't be mean to Chris?
No, I would never let them control me that much. Fuck you.
Alright, good. I'm gonna be more mean to Steelo.
Yeah, fucking turn up the meanness. They're like, oh,
this motherfucker over here.
Yeah, say the N-word like you do off camera.
This. This boy, like just.
You bleep it? Oh, man, you take yourself down for no fucking reason.
No.
You just self cancel. Alana's tired. Ready to watch the fucking TV
Thanks
show
for
undoing.
Hanging out, guys. Hit subscribe. Give us 5 stars if you're still listening on iTunes in your car. I'm talking to you. If you think I'm talking to you right now, if you're like, well, I'm listening to this on iTunes in my car, and I kind of just let this go to the end, and now he's talking. He might be talking to me. I am. I'm talking to you.
My
write us a 5-star review and say, I knew that Chris was talking to me at the end of the last episode. And I will respond to you and say that was you.
My boy said that these YouTubers don't play. Nate, last thing Nate Robinson heard before he got knocked out was like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe.
Well, we'll see you next week. Zip it up.
And Zip It is out. I'm high. We'll be right back.